Hi guys, good morning. So I literally did my intro and then I was like, I can't see perfectly and I didn't have my contacts on. So I'm back. Today we're doing something a little different. We are going to the Gene Autry Museum and I tend to go there from time to time. And especially when they have the free Tuesdays, which is the second Tuesday of every month, just in case you're interested in that. And I really enjoy going there. I love Western and all that type of stuff. So I enjoy seeing the costumes they have. I enjoy seeing the relics they have and just learning new things because they change the exhibit. That being said, I'm just going like this because after I'm also going to the gym. I want to keep it going. Andrew's here. He already did his thing. You can pop in the corner. Good, just exit. Just go there. Boop. No, you should have kept it going.
Was I always?
See, that's what happens when you don't wear your glasses and or contacts, guys. He was like, what did now you're deaf too? But with that being said, Andrew just got back. He had work, then he went to the gym. So he did his things, and I think are you free for the rest of the day?
Today is what, Tuesday?
Tuesday.
Tuesday, 1 o'clock, I got one of those PLF things for class. So pretty much free.
Andrew is allotted a cheat meal. As I've said before in my other videos, we tried the vegan Mexican food. If you guys haven't seen it, I'll leave it up here or down below. Or honestly, at the end of the video, it'll show as well. So he's allotted one cheat meal and he wanted something that I made. I found the recipe, so I must give that. But I recreated it and I've been making it pretty consistently and he loved it, like when he was able to eat normally. So I made it about like 3 days ago and he's just like, yep, that's my cheat meal. I want that and I want boba. So I'm gonna make that happen for him. So I'm gonna go to the museum right now, enjoy myself for a little bit, draw, paint. I do have a little watercolor set. You guys will see my kit. It's nothing big. It's something just, you know, it's been fun. I took it to Columbia with me as well, and it was really fun to just sit and like watercolor paint. And they're pens, so the water is already, you know, you put it in there, you cap it, and then you just, you know, can use it like a regular brush. So I really liked using that just because it allowed me the flexibility where I don't have to just take the water with me everywhere I go. It's already in the brush. So I've been just enjoying doing that. And I did that in Colombia. I did that when I was here as well. But I just really fell in love with just doing simple works like that. So it allows me to kind of just go, if I want to just do it ink or pen or pencil, or if I just want to do a little bit of pencil and then go over with the watercolors, I really, really, really have been liking that. So it just gives me flexibility to do something else. Also, there's been this, well, I don't know if he's a YouTuber, it's loose, but his name is Scott Christian Sevilla, and I'll pull it up here for you guys. So he usually does shorts, so it's not even like full YouTube videos, but his stuff is just so cool. Like you guys can see, I'm really happy for him. He got his 100,000 subscriber plaque. So you guys could just see here. And he works a lot with gouache, watercolor. I actually stumbled upon him because the first thing I saw from him was his love story with his wife, which was really cute because someone had asked, like, do you ever draw your wife? Is she your muse? And he's like, yes, hold up. Let me explain it. So he explained the whole timeline and stuff. And that was really cute. And then while he was also like drawing stuff and painting, so I was like, this guy's really sweet and really cool. So then I followed him and then he just exploded, right? So if you guys are interested in seeing a really cool, chill artist, and also he has a hobbit den, like they made his, it's his basement, but they made his basement into a hobbit den. So cool. And he's just so nice. I don't know. He's really sweet. I'm like, you guys should check him out if you guys are interested in that. So I'll leave his information down below. And with that being said, let's go to the Autry. Okay, so we made it to the Autry. We're gonna go in right now. Parking is easy. It's really windy outside. It doesn't look like it, but it's truly windy. And I have this little bag that I made 3 years ago now, and I was gonna sell it, but I just couldn't let it go. Like the detail, I couldn't do it. So I'm actually gonna use it for when I go on these little art adventures. So yeah, just a corny tidbit. So let's go. Told you it's windy. A few years back, they were actually gonna lose the museum entirely. Thankfully they didn't. I think the Native American Heritage Museum like absorbed it, which is good because they probably have even more knowledge. Alrighty, so we start off in the religion and rituals section. Okay, some of these are new. This one I've seen before. They add different pieces, but we will be talking about that today. So this is the one that kind of stood out to me the most. It is, first of all, it is really, really tall. It's called Witness, and it was part of as you guys can see, like a two-piece installation. But I just like the vibe it had. And I went ahead and I just illustrated it. Nothing too crazy, just a quick sketch. But I like the outfit. I like the positioning. I like how the hood was falling on it. And up close, it was kind of like clay type. So I thought that was really cool too. But just kind of appreciating the artwork for what it is. For the most part, I just like, you know, tend to have an interpretation of it on my own. I obviously read it, but it's kind of cool to see. So I saw these bison chairs and I thought they were really cool. So it's like 18 something and they were made for the Scottish elite. And I was just looking at the seat. I'm like, that actually looks really comfortable to sit on. And I was just taking notes on the details that they have, like the hooves. The back ones are regular, but honestly, it just looks nice that way because it actually looks like it's a little bison. I love the detail of the face. I don't think sitting on it, I'm not too sure if it'd be comfortable on the back, but it looked cool. Then we move on to this dress. This dress I have seen for years. It has literally been here for years because it's old, but also I've seen it for most of my life whenever I've come here. So this one is an unidentified creator, Gilded Age. And I forever say that people were small back then, which is wild to me, just seeing the proportions. So in these rooms, a lot of them, they're really low light, and obviously I understand it's to preserve the artwork. So I put in a couple pictures here with different forms of lighting, I suppose. But I was just really admiring like the brush strokes. I had my contacts on this day because I wanted to see everything. I love looking at details. I love skylines. Like I just love what, I try to figure out what the artist was trying to portray when he painted it. Did he feel good? Did they feel happy? You know, the nature ones are incredible as well. This one with the ships, and there's bigger ones too I didn't catch, but you can look at that. You can see the oil on it. How amazing. So then we moved on to migration and movement. I've seen these forever, and I always come to this one. This is a 1948 Indian, I believe. Yep, the motorcycle, and it just looks badass. That's, you know, I'm just here for the looks on this guy. Like, it looks awesome. I really would love one of these. Like, it just looks incredible. So every time I do come and I happen to swing by and see it, I always get happy. I love the color. I love how they made it look. It just looks like a fun ride. Like, it looks awesome. What do you guys think about it? Look at that. Come on. That looks so cool. So this painting, it kind of made me feel weird because the center point, the focal point, is the bear that's being killed. So they're grabbing it, but I love their outfits, okay? Just artistically speaking, I love the colors. I love how they're portrayed. It kind of gave me this Argentinian vibe. But I just enjoyed the piece overall. Hopefully no bears were harmed in the making of that. Then we move on to, this is supposed to represent like the movies and stuff they had for Western era type. And this is kind of like the end of the silent film era, which I think is really cool. So they put this big old installation right there. They had kind of the talkies, which is the new up and coming thing at the moment back then. So right here, I'm just showing you guys this big old window that I'm going to have in my house one day. That's why I just added it here, because I just wanted to tell you guys that and manifest that, because it's incredible. Come on, look at that. It's beautiful. But once you walk down, this piece right here, I saw it and I was like, that is cool. So you guys will see a lot in the video and all the exhibits. They do include people of color because they existed here. So they have the Chinese folks. And this is the last stake. So that's what they're putting, the last, like that big stake for the railroad. And I think it's important that they portray that. You guys see the teapot, you see the hats. Just really well done. And I appreciate that. This room as well, this is becoming the West. So right here, they have different outfits from different folks. And what was the other one? This one I painted it, but I didn't take a gander at it. The sombrero I really liked. I was staring at that for a good 5-10 minutes. And over here as well, the poncho, it just kind of blows my mind the things that we can still wear today. You guys should read this. And in conclusion, it was basically saying kind of, you know, we'll see these intruders taking over our land. So yeah, you guys can read that. But yeah, that is from Pio Pico. So I also present a still on it so you guys can read about him as well. But the poncho, incredible. It's crazy that it's that old. The sombrero, crazy that it's that old, but I did quick sketches of those too, and I just really, really, really loved looking at them. Like, I'm just weird in that way. So you guys can see mid-19th century, okay? It's just crazy. And it was worn by Pio Pico. And the serape también. So it's just kind of like, I don't know. Kind of makes me feel a bunch of feels. Do you guys like looking at stuff in museums, or just me? Like, I don't know. I get all up close as I can, and kind of examine the pieces, everything, especially clothes, obviously. But it's just something about seeing that, like, look at all this beauty, seeing about that and acknowledging that folks lived here before, the bison lived here before. One of the tour guides that was there, actually, I got lucky enough, and they were saying, oh yeah, like, people think this is a buffalo, but no, it's a bison. And I'm like, yeah, it's a bison, California bison. But yeah, so I was just kind of eavesdropping on their conversations, and it was really cool. So I got to see this is the freaking gold nugget, and then that's how they compounded and made into the little block. And I'm like, that's crazy, just seeing these things, like, I don't know. And once again, look at that, Native Americans, that they made incredible stuff with such good quality, and you could just sense the love and care in each garment. I love their stuff. Incredible pieces. So then we're going to talk about how when they would go in the stagecoaches, they would carry their toiletries. Look at that. They have the whole little toiletry. Like, what? They have like their little, I don't know. It just baffled me. I'm like, well, these people were like us. But, you know, obviously, back then, I don't know. I know it sounds so silly to say it out loud, but I don't know. To me, it just makes me think, and I'm like, what? People are people all over. So this was in essence a stagecoach. So they would take folks to places. When they were doing the big missions and stuff, it would take like 18 months. So, and I wasn't in this one, you know, it'd be like the other wagons, but can you imagine 18 months? Take all them little toiletries and everything. I would be just, geez, I'm just grateful, you know, that we have other means of transportation. But yeah, they were really leveraging on that, the Pony Express, and they were, you know, these are the things that they had, just some of the things, obviously, and, you know, they were obviously concerned for for people who were trying to rob them, you know? But yeah, look at this. I don't know, this blows my mind, too. That's a Pony Express. It's a stamp.
So they do the advertising, guys. Like, that's crazy. And over here, this exhibit, I think this one was my favorite. This one is the communities. So as you guys can see, they have all different types of people, and I love that because it addresses how all of us, or all the people, have come together to make America what it is, which I think is very important. I showed Andrew this. This is Mahjong, and I'm like, what? Because Andrew's mom plays that, and I'm like, that's so cool. Also a dictionary that translates Chinese. I'm not sure if it's Mandarin or Cantonese. Excuse my ignorance on that. But yeah, so I thought it was really cool that it respectfully showed, you know, how folks lived back then, what they wore, and also explain, you know, their religious beliefs, which I thought was very respectful and very awesome. A lot of things I didn't know, and that's why we like learning stuff. Obviously, they have a Mexican section. I thought it was a little bit, like, lacking, but I did like these maps, too. They were showing, like, where folks were. Then for Native American, I mean, I apologize, for African Americans, they'd show like all the suits where folks would volunteer for war. And then we have the Canadians too, which I was like, what? I didn't know Canadians were in the US, but they are. So this is a steam engine, and the gentleman was saying that they did have Dalmatians, and they would tend to calm down the horses, and they just, I don't know, I guess they worked well together, so that's why you see it. Oh, and this in particular is just nightmare fuel. I just wanted to fuel you guys with fears. This is a foot, like a pedal, like you pedal it. And that's a dentist chair. So you guys can fill it in. And I'm sorry. And also, you're welcome. Then we have the Votes for Women sash. This, I don't know, it just kind of made it so, I don't know, real that we had to like vouch and fight for a vote. It's wild, guys. Like, you know, going to museums and stuff, like I had posted on Instagram, there's a lot of chaos and things, a lot of messed up things and a lot of things that it's just like, oof. But it also kind of just makes us realize a lot of things as well. Like, wow, we get to do that. Or wow, people had to fight for that. Or, you know, just kind of puts it a little bit into perspective. I won't get too much in it, but I'll leave it at that. Okay, so real quick, I just had to insert this still of myself because going forward, I'm just going to go ham and show you guys all the things that I saw in this upcoming room. There was a saloon, there was the bar, the back bar, there was poker tables and roulette tables and hidden freaking things for cards and cheaters and baby guns, like tiny guns, like I don't know, you guys will just see. So this is truly what it's like being with me in a museum.
Guys. Okay, this is literally my face. I'm like, okay for it. It's a fucking saloon. It's an actual saloon. Oh my god. Oh my god, I live here. I'm following the tour guide while I'm like painting. This is amazing. I love it. I'm actually gonna try to make some of this. So here it is. You guys could do it too. I won't tell.
Yeah, Budweiser.
Oh my gosh. Look, they had the little thing. Can you imagine? This is literally how to be. I'd be like, order up. I don't want to get kicked out, but this is so cool. I'm so dorky, but what? Ye olde music? Okay. I'm just, what? balloon, but it was just made that way. It was a back bar. Awesome. Come burrito salad. That's cool. Look at this. This is an oh my god, it's a coin operated. 1915. Guys, I've lost control. Amazing. Wow. Oh my god, guys. You're not gonna believe it. It's a roulette table. And a poker table. What the? What? Look at this. All the cards. Poker set. Look at that. Wow. Is that amethyst? Pearl or what? Oh, yep. Leather bound case. Mother approach. Psst. Oh, that's what I want, that baby gun. Pew pew. Oh my god, look guys, this is when they were cheating. Oh my god. Look, see you. Ridiculous. Sometimes people have been trash. Bucking the tiger. Saloons and establishments frequently offered various types of gambling. Whether a friendly game of cards or a high stake match, games of chance existed to suit all. Bucking the tiger became a common challenge. Merchant and miner alike took a chance, a crowded round of roulette. Professional gamblers oftentimes rented tables in gambling saloons, sometimes just to remain in the same location. Cheating was common practice, as were rigged confidence games and other rackets. The potential for violence. Many gamblers carried concealed weapons. Oh, that's why the little gun was worn. Jesus. Is that a spit jar? Look how little the table. Oh my god, look how little the chairs are. But the people are so small, guys, so it doesn't surprise me. Old school Wheel of Fortune. Ugh, that's so cool.
So overall, like, you guys could just see this one was all the guns, and I was like, oh boy, okay, let's just go on to puppies. And then we just have these. This was a calendar. I'm like, that looks sick. Inspiration, all aboard. This color, guys, I just want to show you guys that. So this one is Annie Oakley. So she was a champion markswoman, a Buffalo Bills Wild West show. And just watch her. Just let's take a moment to just see how she freaking shoots. Incredible. Her husband actually gave her these guns. So they're full gold. They're so beautiful. And the handle is Mother of Pearl. So, Miss Oakley, you got a good husband with good taste. So, this one over here is just Vaqueros, the first cowboys, which I also like that they put that and threw that in there and acknowledged that. And they had over here La Fiesta de Los Angeles. So this was just kind of showing the fantasy that folks had with Spaniard, like Spaniardism, you know, their clothing, their style, and all of that. And talking about just kind of how that was a thing. The saddle looks amazing, all of that. They would win pins and stuff. So as you guys can see, yeah, the Spanish fantasy. And I did a little still for you guys to appreciate the garments as well. Again, small people, but beautiful construction, beautiful colors. I love it. This quote is actually very sad. So, been a beautiful day, but a very lonesome one for me. Thinking of my little family, do hope they are well and doing well. So, with that being said, they would take all these young men in particular, and they would either have no families or just be complete orphans, or at least, you know, be willing to go with them. And they would have these folks out just venturing and stuff. I didn't know what a chuck wagon was until I saw this. I was like, I've never seen that. I was like, what? So, all of this, as you guys can see, sorry, it's a little like close shot, but that would whip out and then you could put the little leg up and then you can go ahead and just, you know, ride along, herd cattle, do your thing, go work. And if you needed to eat, usually it'd be enough food for 30 days. You guys can see the water barrel right there. So right there, 30 days. The grinder. Do you guys see that grinder? Because they had coffee. I don't know why in my head I'm like, what? I feel like people were so, I don't know, they thought of things more back then. I feel like everything's too easy for us in a sense nowadays, you know? But this is kind of like what they would eat. And this longhorn was in the other room, but I came back specifically because I wanted to draw it. And as soon as I just drew it, I was content. I painted it later, but I was really happy. Then the last room was exploring all of natural elements and also seeing what different native people lived in California, which was very interesting. I didn't know there were so many. Like, did you guys know? 'Cause I didn't know. Oh, I like this. So this is plant species by diversity and endemic plants. California got number one, which did surprise me. And over here is all the way on the bottom floor. They have kind of just this mural of everybody, which I thought was pretty cool. But with that being said, that's going to be it for us today. Thank you so much for joining me on this marvelous adventure, and I will see you on the next one.